So in this lecture, we talk about Galois correspondence of finite fields. So we start with the polynomial this xpn minus x lying over this finite field of characteristic p. So this polynomial is separable and has splitting field fpn. So this we showed in the lecture on finite fields. So this lecture is a continuation of previous lecture on finite fields. Now you have a separable polynomial, you have a splitting field, so you can talk about the Galois group of our polynomial. So which is group of automorphisms of fpn which keeps fp fixed. So in the previous lecture we showed that this degree of extension is n, and now this n is precisely the size of the Galois group. So notice that this fpn was generated by roots of our polynomial which we are talking about here, right here. So we have this Frobenius automorphism which will take a to the power of p like this. This automorphism is injective and surjective. So we are working in a field of characteristic p to the power of n. So in the lecture on finite fields, we showed this for field of characteristic p and a finite field. So that proof will carry over word for p to the power of n. So now if you apply phi twice to a, so first time you apply, you get a to the power of p. Again you apply, you get p again, so you get ap square. So you apply I times, you get api. So if you apply it n times, you get apn. But this a lies here, so that it is a root of f. So if you put apn minus a, this will be equal to 0. So you get apn equals to a. So if you apply phi n, it is as good as applying the identity map. So the order is n here. So again, precisely because a is a root of this equation, since a lies in fpn and fpn is generated by roots. So the Galois group is completely generated by this phi, and this phi has order n, and this is a cyclic group. So since it's a cyclic group, you can write it as z over nz. Now the Galois correspondence gives us subfields of fpn over fp. They are in one-to-one correspondence with subgroups of z over nz. So what are the subgroups of this? So we know from group theory that for each divisor d of n, so every number which divides n, we have a subgroup which is generated by phi d. And this subgroup will obviously have order m, which is m is equal to n over d. So the corresponding subfield is fpd. So again, you know, this phi d, you put d here, you get apd, and that's what generates fpd. So obviously this is generated by apd. So now a is a root of such an equation, apd minus a. You have an equation corresponding to this is xpd minus x, and so on. So since this is an abelian group, all its subgroups are normal. So therefore, all extensions are Galois extensions. So all such extensions are Galois extensions. So again, you have one-to-one correspondence. You have intermediate fields and subgroups of this z over nz. So fpn is 1, fpz over nz. Corresponding to fpd, you have z over mz, where m is precisely n over d. So we can also talk about this fpd over fp. For that you will have to take subgroup which is generated by this. You have to have phi, which is z over nz, divided by subgroup generated by this, which is phi d. So the corresponding subgroup, so you modulo phi d out of it, will give you this extension fpd over fp. So this over this. So this is generated by this subgroup. So this is a factor group, and this is a normal subgroup because this is an abelian group. So now an important remark for algebraic closures. So we have seen if D divides N, you can have this order. FPD is contained within FPN. There's some ordering like this. So therefore we have some partial order. So this partial order can help us construct the algebraic closure of this finite field FP. So algebraic closure of this, you put a bar on FP, denotes algebraic closure. This is just union of or n greater or equal to 1 FPN. So this gives you, so you have ordering here, you can think of it as a subset here. So you have this partial ordering, and this gives you algebraic closure like this.